Hello and welcome to the ProYaki Report, Volume 1, Episode 39, Scoring Late. I'm Michael Westbay, your host. Back on Episode 136, Starters vs. Relievers, Part 3, Gibson-san, of the Japan Baseball Weekly podcast fame, suggested digging a bit deeper into the separation of starters versus relievers. But instead of checking out specifically how starters and relievers have done, check out how teams have done through the first six innings and the last three, adjusted if there were extra innings concerned, of course. Because the request was kind of open-ended, I decided to interpret it as being, to look around at the scoring before and after the 6th-7th inning split and see how teams did in terms of turning a game around after that point. That is to say, I checked after the end of 6 innings to find what the status of the game was. For example, the home team is either winning, losing, or the game is tied. I then checked what the final score was in the game, and here again, the home team is either winning, losing, or the game is tied. And as a first step, what I did was I just listed all of the line scores where the game status differed from the end of the 6th inning to the final result. For example, a team is winning after 6, they lose at the end of the game. That's there. And what I found is basically that almost every day there is a late game turnaround going on. But I really kind of want something a little more solid, more solid numbers, summations, in fact. And to that end, I queried my database. So that's what I did. I gathered all games up through Thursday, September 19th, that went 9 innings or more. Turns out there's only one game that did not make it 9 innings, that between Nakuten and Seibu. I compared the runs scored and runs allowed through the 6th inning, the end of 6, that is, from the 7th inning on and over the final 3 innings, which would include extra innings, as from the 7th on would also include extra innings. But with extra inning games, you eliminate the 7th inning, perhaps the 8th, perhaps the 9th, you get the picture. Nonetheless, the raw data can be found on the Google Drive spreadsheet, which I'm linking to in the show notes on both the Google Plus ProYaku community version of this video and the Bayside West Yokohama embedded video on JapaneseBaseball.com. Your feedback is most welcome at either of these locations. Now, if runs were distributed evenly over all innings, then one would expect something close to 66% over the first 6 innings and 33% over the remainder of the game. Of course, extra innings will throw that off a bit, tilting in favor of scoring runs after the 7th. And Yokohama, with a 65 to 35% ratio between the first 6 innings and the remainder of the game, is the only team that fits this, what I would think, a reasonable assumption. While Yokohama is on the low end of scoring early, Nipponham and Oryx, the bottom two teams in the Pacific League, are to the opposite extreme, scoring 75 and 76% of their runs in the first 6 innings, respectively. So, how does this affect Gyakuten or come-from-behind victories? Well, it turns out that Yokohama and the Giants, who scored the lowest percentage of their runs in the first six innings, lead both leagues in come-from-behind victories, with 11 each. In games that they win after losing through six innings, both teams score just around a quarter of their runs over the first six innings, while allowing 85% to 95% of their runs over that time. The secret for both teams appears to be shutting down the opposition from the seventh inning on and scoring a lot of runs over the same period. Yokohama's 53 runs scored from the seventh inning over these 11 Gyakuten victories, 51 of them in the final three innings, is simply outrageous. So, what about failing to hold the lead? It turns out that Hiroshima and Chunichi seem to be having the worst time holding on to a lead from the seventh inning on, losing 12 and 10, respectively. The top two teams in the Central League, the Giants and Tigers, only suffered 2 and 4 Gyakuten losses from the seventh inning on. So, if they're leading after six innings, chances are pretty good that these two teams are going to hold on to that lead. Those of you wondering about that blank alignment field in the data I've presented today, well, that's to compare home and away. The data is available, once again, on Google Drive, the link being available on either the Google Plus Pro Yaku community or the JapaneseBaseball.com Bayside West Yokohama blog, where you'll find this video embedded. Now, how does being on the road affect coming from behind? I leave that as an exercise for you viewers. And I would like to especially thank John for the idea of this week's report. And speaking of Gibson-san, this week's Japan Baseball Weekly podcast will be coming out tomorrow, September 23rd. In it, they will feature an interview with John Boker. They'll discuss Kato Kantoku's retirement over Ballgate, Makun's continuing winning streak, and Chunichi's Iwase hitting a milestone. I look forward to the show. I'm sure you do too. And with that, I submit to you this week's Pro Yaku Report. Thank you for joining me, and until next week, take care.